Who let you in here? Oh, sister!
Save your breath. She's on a break.
You better not touch me again. I've told Davo everything.
Oh, that's a pity. Because it's only your word against mine. And you've already earned yourself quite a reputation for telling tales, haven't you?
But they know I'm not lying this time. Look at me. I didn't do this to myself, did I?
Then you'll just have to change your story. The women have had it in for you for a long time. Everyone knows that. And anything could have happened after I left the cell. Couldn't it? So you're going to have to soft pedal this issue, because I can make things very painful for you, and not just physically. Yes, it all depends how much you want that kid of yours. And then there's the question of me appearing to discredit you as a mother.
Oh, you bloody bitch.
Just tell the truth.
Which is?
That you fought to the end and I had to defend myself.
That's crap.
I hope I don't have to pay another visit.
What are you doing in this area?
I wanted to see how Latham is.
Yes, well, I would forget about her if I were you, at least until her injuries have been explained.
It wasn't easy getting her under control. You know what she's like. She doesn't give in quickly. She'll tell you that herself if you can get her to admit it.
I'll be speaking to her when she's up to it. Now, meanwhile, I'd suggest you submit your own report to Mrs. Davidson on the incident.
Tell me, Mrs. Powell, have you ever been threatened by a prisoner?
Of course. But I've never found it necessary to go as far as you did. Mr. Douglas is waiting with Mrs. Davidson. He may wish to discuss this with you.
Oh, is it that time already?
Already?
It's been the longest day of my life.
Any more news about Chrissy?
No. I tried speaking to her, but she wasn't up to it. Oh, I don't know. It worries me, Meg. We can't have this sort of thing happening.
I just can't believe Joan would be so stupid.
Afternoon, ladies.
Oh, good afternoon, Inspector Grace. What can we do for you?
I want to speak to Donna Mason.
I was trying to contact you earlier, actually. I believe you're looking for Susie Driscoll.
Yes, but not now, Mrs. Morris. I'm in a hurry.
Okay. I'll get Mason.
Thanks. You know we had Susie in here with us for a while.
Yes. Yes, I do. The way she's going, it won't be long before she's back again.
Yeah, come on, when do we eat? We're all present and correct, so what's the hold-up?
Hey, wait a minute, where's Chrissy?
Latham won't be joining you for the evening meal.
Oh, we must have left her off the invitation list by mistake.
Okay, but quiet.
My name's Philwell. Can I see the sister?
No.
Mrs. Powell, I want to see the sister because I feel sick.
I've already told you no, Mason.
The sister isn't on duty, but if you're not well, you can see her in the morning. Let the women through to the dining room, please, Miss Ferguson. All except Mason. She's got a visitor.
All right, you lot, don't push. None of you look as if you're starving to death.
She was only sent here as a last resort. I mean, she hasn't got a criminal record or anything.
Yeah, okay, Mrs. Morris. Now, look, when do I see Mason? I am in a hurry.
Look, they won't be long. Susie's very young and naive. She could have got mixed up with the wrong crowd. I mean, she might need help.
Mrs. Morris, I'm a copper. I'm not interested in juvenile rehabilitation. Now, if little Susie can help me get some bigger fish, like the pushers or the dealers, well, then I'll give her all the help she needs. If not, she's history as far as I'm concerned. If I worried about every little mole that cat... Good. Now, where can I see Mason?
You can't. She refuses to speak to you.
Well, she doesn't know where Susie is. I've already spoken to her.
Well, we mustn't upset the ladies, must we, Mrs. Morris? Let me know if she changes her mind, will you?
What'd you find out?
From him? Mm. Absolutely nothing. Honestly, one session with him, and I'm beginning to understand the women's attitude towards the police.
Don't let him upset you. It's just the way it works.
Thought you were going home.
Oh, so did I. Joan Barfield's sick. I'll have to hang around. Serves me right, huh?
Here, I'll get it for you. Thanks.
Hey, I wouldn't do anything to hurt Susie. I was just sick and I needed help, Hannah, because I was really sick and I wouldn't hurt her, honest, I wouldn't.
Well, I never met her, so I don't know.
Listen, one thing. Stop talking about your habit in here. Dope is real bad news, and you may have noticed that Bea doesn't like it.
Come on, Dory, hurry up. When you've finished your meal, I want you to go down to the kitchen and get a tray and take it up to the hospital.
Okay, but who's sick?
Never mind. Just report to me when you've finished.
Come to a brick and squishy Latham, eh, Mrs. Morris? Ho ho. The plot thickens.
What do you reckon's going on, Bea?
Well, we won't know until you get up there and find out, will we? You better hurry up and eat.
Everybody's always telling me what to do.
Yeah.
Bloody hell, what happened to you?
Let's just say I had a freak accident.
The freak?
Put the tray down, please, Doreen. Mr. Douglas will see you as soon as you finish your lunch.
Thanks, Mrs. M.
Righto, what gives?
Pal B, you should see Chrissy. It looks as though somebody's been using her for a footy.
Ah, so she did get into a brawl.
Yeah, well, she couldn't say very much because Mrs. Morris was there all the time. But something's up.
Well, it could have been anyone. Chrissy didn't exactly make inmate of the month.
Yeah, well, she said that she'd had a freak accident.
Oh, what? Don't tell me she'd be stupid enough to take on Ferguson.
She mightn't have had any say in it.
But Ferguson wouldn't leave her looking like that. The department would have her out in her ear.
In that case, I hope it is her. Maybe she won't get away with it.
Yeah, and better it happened to Chrissy than any one of us.
Well, fair enough. But that doesn't alter the fact we've got a bad screw on our hands. And just think, next time it could be one of you.
How are you feeling now, Chrissy?
I'll live.
I'd like you to tell Mr. Douglas exactly what you told us earlier.
I've already spoken to Miss Ferguson, Latham, so stay as close to the truth as you can.
I lost control. I attacked Miss Ferguson.
Go on.
Well, I thought I'd knocked her out at first, but I hadn't, so I had another go. Well, I had to, didn't I? I mean, she would have clobbered me.
Is this what you brought me into here? It's not the first time an officer's been attacked, you know?
Is that all you have to say, Chrissy?
Yeah, that's it. Oh, yeah. It won't happen again. And I'm sorry.
Yes.
I really don't see why you called me on this one, Erica.
You don't really believe she's telling the truth, do you?
Well, we can only ask what happened, and according to Latham, Miss Ferguson was telling the truth.
And what about her injuries?
Oh, for God's sake, the woman attacked an officer.
Chrissy Latham has cracked ribs, contusions, a split lip, and a black eye. Miss Ferguson has a bump on the head. I want to know what I'm to do about it.
Nothing.
You can't be serious.
Very much so. As I see it, Miss Ferguson had no option but to defend herself.
I see. Of course, the minister wouldn't like the scandal, would he? Not to mention the officers might go on strike if we took action against a union member.
Do you have something else to do, Mrs. Parr?
Of course.
All right, Erica, what is it you want?
I want more information on Joan Ferguson's service in Queensland.
You've seen her record.
Records have been known to be whitewashed, both prisoners and officers.
Why are you making such an issue of this? Miss Ferguson was totally justified in defending herself. I think you just should forget the whole thing. Now, obviously, Latham is prepared to.
She wasn't before you arrived. Something is wrong, Ted, and I want to know what it is. Yes? These reports on the Chrissy Latham incident need clarification.
Oh, in what way, Governor?
Your report states that the prisoner attacked you from behind and you had to subdue her.
Yes, that's what happened.